Good morning, everyone. So we are here at Disney World's Animal Kingdom, and I'm so very excited to be back, especially during Christmas, as you can see this beautiful Christmas tree behind me. But I'm very excited to be able to get on some rides like Expedition Everest, Flight of Passage, Dinosaur, but also to be able to catch some shows like the Finding Nemo show, the Lion King Festival. It's tough to be a bug because they are taking that away. So I kind of want to catch it at least one more time in case I don't watch it before they take it away. But, you know, and I also want to be able to do the Imagination Station where you get on the train and you go to Rafiki's. I am so excited for that. I have never done it before. So then it does look like it's going to rain today. So I really want to catch the safari before it starts raining and all the animals go inside. It is officially 8 o'clock. The park is open and we are going to Avatar Flight of Passage because we have a lightning lane at 8:06. And I love this ride. It's really cool how they made it. If you've never ridden it before, it's kind of like Soarin' in Epcot, but a whole different like seat system. And it is so amazing. But look how beautiful the Tree of Life is. Just seeing all these animals sculpted into the tree, it's really beautiful. Welcome to the Valley of Memora. I love Pandora and it is truly so beautiful at night. The ground is painted in neon colors. So when it's night and it's they have these ultraviolet lights that pulls out these, you know, paint, it is truly so beautiful. Every time I'm here in Pandora and I just see all of this thought and architecture, it just shows you how much, you know, work and designing and thought and imagination it took to build this Pandora. We are finally here at Pandora Flight of Passage. The standby wait time is 55 minutes, but of course we have lightning lane and it is time to get on Flight of Passage. Look how empty this queue line is for lightning lane of Avatar's Flight of Passage.
Hi, and welcome to the Avatar program. Soon, you're going to have a chance to undertake an amazing Navi rite of passage. Riding on the back of a banshee by being genetically matched and linked to an avatar.
Welcome, everyone. I'm Dr. Jackie Ogden from the Pandora Conservation Initiative. You're about to experience a ceremony that's very special to the Navi, flying on the back of an Ikran, or as we call it, a banshee. To the Navi, connecting to an Ikran and flying on its back is an incredibly important rite of passage they call Ikni Maya. You'll experience the breathtaking beauty of Pandora, but you might also face some of its greatest challenges. Some of this flight might be intense, but trust your guide and be brave. As the Navi say during this important rite of passage, Sivako, rise to the challenge.
Thank you.
We just got off of Avatar's Flight of Passage, and that truly is an amazing ride. It's just so cool and so amazing that you get to get on a Banshee and, you know, just be matched with an Ikran. Like, it is truly, truly so amazing. And it's one ride that we will definitely be riding again, but Sivako. And now it's time to head to Expedition Everest. When you're at Animal Kingdom, you have to pay attention to these waters because they do some character meet and greets from the boats here. The characters will actually float down the little river right here and wave at you and just have a very cool interaction, even though it's distance from afar. I will always point out this because it is truly beautiful. The back of the Tree of Life. Usually right in front of the Tree of Life coming from the entrance, it usually is busy. But a lot of people don't usually stop right here behind it to get some pictures of it. And it's one of the unique spots that's underrated. Look at this, the monkeys are out. There's more monkeys. Look how beautiful Expedition Everest looks right now. I'm so excited to get on that ride. Look at this, they have a stuffed pancake sandwich with sausage, guava paste, egg, and cheese available at the Trek Snack. So we finally made it to Expedition Everest. And if anyone knows me, I usually go to the single rider, but today we have Lightning Lane. Expedition Everest is so amazing. So if you have never ridden Expedition Everest, the theme of this ride is the Yeti and Mount Everest. And the queue line is kind of themed to that aspect of, like, more so of like climbing mountains and gear. And of course, the Yeti. This ride is so amazing. I remember when I went back to back to back 9 times riding this ride. 9 times. It truly has been way too long since I have been on Expedition Everest. And I'm so excited. I love that you can see the Tower of Terror and Spaceship Earth and Guardians of the Galaxy from here. We just got off of Expedition Everest, and look how cute these little plushies are for the Yeti. $34.99. And of course, you can use your annual pass discount for it. Now look at the spirit jersey for Expedition Everest. I actually like that. That's pretty cool. Let's see what this price is. $79.99. I like this Animal Kingdom, you know, styled merchandise and this lounge fly. It's a unique one because it's not usually like this for lounge flies. Actually, pretty cool. $78. That's not bad for a lounge fly. And look at these Animal Kingdom ears. Let's see. It has officially started to drizzle or sprinkle. And it's not what I want right now, but it's definitely not terrible, and it's not the worst thing. I would rather be raining and a little bit of wind than it be hot and I'd be sweaty. And the one thing about the rain is I would rather be here at Animal Kingdom or Disney in a whole and it'd be raining and windy, because any rainy day is better than a sunny day somewhere else. One day we are going to do Feathered Friends in Flight. But right now it's raining, so I don't know if the stadium right here has shade. We just made it to the Kilimanjaro Safaris. It is a 10-minute standby wait, but we have lightning lane. And I did want to show you right here in front of it. This is where you check in for the animal tours. And one day I really want to do the tour.
The lighter colored antelope are greater kudu. Those are females because only males have horns. To the right, there is an okapi. They do have black and white stripes on their legs, but they are not related to the zebra. They are the closest living relative of the giraffe. They have similar skull structures and they both have long prehensile tongues, which means that they use their tongues to grab their food. There is a
Look
Nile
at that. I really want to do that tour so bad. I would love to do that tour.
And while they do know how to swim, it's easier for them to sink down to the bottom of the river and walk along it. The Nile hippopotamus. They can be in groups of up to 200 that are called a float.
Float.
Hippos have grass.
Look how cool
they
it is to be on the safari during the wane.
They are able to eat about 60 to 90 pounds of stripe pattern, so no two are the same, kind of like human fingerprints. These zebras have black noses, which tells us that they are black with white stripes. If they consist of an adult male, a couple of adult female, and their offspring. To the left, laying inside of that cave, there are painted dogs. They are one of the most efficient predators with prey until the prey drops from exhaustion. They can be in packs of up to 30, led by both a dominant male and a dominant female who make up the primary mating pair of the pack. Due to habitat loss, there are less than 3,000 painted dogs left in the wild. The sable antelope, both males and females have horns. A fully grown adult male's horns can reach 5 feet long. They use their horns to protect themselves from predators. Springbok get their name because they are able to spring 6 feet when they are frightened in a jump called the cronk. They are one of the top 10 fastest land mammals, able to reach speeds of 55 miles per hour. At one point, the springbok was critically endangered, but today they are one of the most populated antelope. Tall, and the adult males are 16 to 20 feet tall. When a giraffe is born, they make about a 6 foot drop into the world because they give birth standing up. Giraffes only need about 30 minutes of sleep a day, and since they spend so much time awake, they will spend up to 22 hours out of the day to help cool down. They can also use their trunks to pick up dirt, mud, and hay, and fling it onto their back. An elephant's trunk has more muscles than the entire human body does. And they are able to hold up to 5 gallons of water, but they do not drink through their trunk like a straw. Instead, they will suck water up and then spray it into their mouths in the habitats of elephants and gorillas. They are afraid of bees. So we told the farmers if you line your farm with beehives, the buzzing would scare them off. That protected elephants from angry farmers, and it also protected crops from elephant feet. The farmers were then able to sell the honey that the beehives were making, so it was an all-around win for everyone involved. A lot of energy, so they will only do so for a couple hundred yards. They use their long tails as a boat-like rudder to change direction while they sprint. They are the only big cat whose claws do not retract, so their claws are out all of the time. Now to the right-hand side, there are those white rhinos that I mentioned. White rhinos get their name not from their color, but from a mistranslation, like our youngest and her mother there. Speeds of 42 miles per hour by running on just two of their toes.
It is now time for Rafiki's Planet Watch. I don't think I've ever done this. It is pouring down raining, but I am enjoying my time here. Like, nothing can ruin my day here at Disney. But here in Rafiki's Planet Watch, we're going to hop on a train, go to Imagination Station, where they teach you how to learn how to draw certain Disney characters. You can meet domesticated animals like goats, and I'm very excited to be able to go here.
Did you know Bambi was the first animated feature to bring live animals into the studio? In the 1940s, Walt Disney and his animators modeled characters from the film after the movements and natural behaviors of their real-life counterparts. even with the latest advances in computer animation. This tradition continues today as animators travel throughout the world to observe animals in their own surroundings. And that includes here in Disney's Animal Kingdom. As we approach Conservation Station, a few reminders.
And I am so excited to see what this has to offer. The animation experience at Conservation Station, the sketch times are 10, 10:45, 11:30, 12:15, 1:45, 2:30, 3:15, 4, and 4:45. Look, we see Rafiki! We are here at Conservation Station, and I wanted to be a Wilderness Explorer. So we got the Wilderness Explorer book, and we actually got our first sticker. We got our Habitat Badge, where you find animal friends near your home and you make them a home for you. Look at this. Look how cool this looks. I am so excited. Look at the elephant, the cheetah, the snake, the panda, the rhino, the gorilla, the wolf. We just walked in and oh my gosh. Look at how detailed this room is with all these animals. I am in love right now. Look at this. They have the animation experience going right now. I am loving this right now. We are right here at the Animal Health and Care and look behind the scenes in the Science Center. And look at this. I am loving this. This is so cool. Look at this. This is the veterinarian office right here for all the animals. You can actually watch actual procedures happen right here. We just got our second batch, the veterinarian badge, to make a diagnosis. And at 11 o'clock today, they actually have a wellness procedure happening. Look at this, we got a desert rosy boa. Look at this, a crocodile skull. I just got my third badge, the animal nutrition badge. Don't feed wild animals. I am really collecting these stickers for these badges.
And dedication to animal care, to our work to save wildlife, and our support of conservation heroes. Disney Conservation Fund is committed to ensuring a world where wildlife thrives and inspiring all of us to treasure and protect the magic of nature.
We blend the love of nature and a respect for animals that Walt Disney always had himself with making dreams come true, getting people excited about nature and about being out in the wild.
Look at how good some of these people are. I'm going to head out from Conservation Station. I will come back at a later date to do the sketch drawing and also watch some of the procedures and then also meet some of the domesticated animals. But we're going to go watch the Festival of the Lion King show, and I'm very excited.
We hope you take with you a great appreciation for the very journey that led us here. You see, it was Walt Disney's passion for animals and conservation that led him to send film crews across the globe to capture dramatic footage of wildlife in remote locations.
We just made it to the Festival of the Lion King.
Thank you. And now, I present to you His Majesty, the Lion King.
Let's settle down! For the last time, I love quiet!
Thank you, Maestro,
if you please.
Hakuna Matata! What a wonderful phrase! Let's hear it for Gatama Games!
Is simply why I became undisputed and respected, shared and seen for the world I am. It's my deep and ambitions of men being repaired. It's my deep and ambitions of men being repaired.
I really do love the Festival of the Lion King show. I think the monkeys and the fire guy, they sell the show. They are both amazing. But we are on our way to the Finding Nemo show. We do got Lightning Lane and it is pouring down raining right now. We finally made it.
Let us all sign a prayer.
Not friends, not friends. You traveled far. You must be swimming under a monkey's
And the Finding Nemo show is really good. We got some amazing seats right there, kind of in the front row, where you got to see close-up of the characters. And that was a cool experience for me because I've never had that. But the show's really good. But I am a sucker for The Lion King, so I would have to say that the Finding Nemo is probably my second favorite here. I am loving that they actually decorated Dinoland USA for Christmas. They got little Christmas trees, they got garland, and of course they got Donald Duck and Daisy. Look at them, they look so cool. They look so cute. That's why Donald's number one right there. It is now time to ride Dinosaur. The standby wait time is 10 minutes, but we have a lightning lane.
Hello there. Welcome to our little trans-dimensional joyride, folks.
I always point this out, but this smell is so very unique to this ride. And it's one of those smells that, like, you love it or hate it.
In T-minus 10 seconds and counting.
This is Seeker. Listen up. We've got to get in, grab the iguanodon, and get out before the asteroid hits. Let's roll.
Now, let's go get that dino. Computer, what are you tracking?
Styracosaurus.
Not our dino.
Warning, meteor shower in range.
Just little one.
We're not gonna make it! We're not gonna make it!
Mission accomplished.
You made it!
I know you would, and guess you made it back with you. I better find it before security does.
So I just got off a Dinosaur, and I love this ride. This is one ride that is like my old faithful, that if the park is busy and the wait times are outrageous, you can always count on Dinosaur. It's time to watch It's Tough to Be a Bug at the Tree of Life Theater. The standby wait time is 10 minutes, but we have a lightning lane. I love this show, It's Tough to Be a Bug. It's funny because a lot of people don't know what to expect, and then a lot of kids start screaming and crying at the end of it. That's sad, but it is funny to kind of see people's first time reactions to it. And it is really sad to see that they are going to be replacing it with the Zootopia show. So it's nice to be able to watch this show at least one more time before they replace it. And I love seeing this side of the Tree of Life and all the animals close up. I think that's really cool. Look at the elephants. Look at these animals. I love the Tree of Life right here. It is so amazing. Look at the lions. I love the Tree of Life. Like, I know I say it a lot, but these animals carved into the tree just makes you understand that they are all one. All animals are one. We are all one. We are one together. Look at the gorilla. Look at this theater. One thing I love about Animal Kingdom is Walt Disney's original dream for a theme park was to have live animals. And that was in Magic Kingdom. He created the Jungle Cruise and he wanted live animals. But then his, you know, fellow Imagineers talked him out of it, said that that's not feasible for a theme park. So when it came to the Jungle Cruise, they made animatronics. All the animals in the Jungle Cruise are animatronics. And so when it came to creating Walt Disney's dream after he passed away, they thought of Magic Kingdom, a whole entire park dedicated to live animals, conservation ship, and doing everything they can to help animals not go extinct.
This means war!
Guys, we caught our first character on the water. We got Pluto. Oh, he's got a Christmas collar. Look at one day soon, I really want to eat Tiffin's restaurant But also, I do want to go to the Nomad Lounge. Like, this is on my bucket list. The Nomad Lounge has the Hightower Rocks, the Casa Dragons, Blanca Tequila, Watermelon Sweet and Sour, and Lime Juice. The Gin's Tattoo with Kettle One Vodka, Watermelon Hibiscus, and Lime Juice. Tempting Tigress, the Russell's Reserve 10-Year Bourbon, St. Elizabeth Allspice Dram Liqueur, Tamarind, and Lime Juice. The Lamu Libration, the Star African Rum, Crimson Banana Rum, Wave Parade, Tropical Juices, and Gosling's 151 Rum Floats, the Snow Leopard Salvation, and the Anna Progazine. But then they also have small plates, the Nomad Bowls, the Chicken Matron, and then Poke Tuna. They got some Impossible Sliders, Tiffin's Bread Service, Churros.
Land, star, or even the outreaches of space! This festive travel always
produce a dynamic. Well, we're still here in Pandora and we've seen the Wilderness Explorer, and I got sacked because my book is wet, but I want me a new badge. I got my botany badge. Plants help the planet. It is now time for Navi River Journey. The standby wait time is 30 minutes, but we have a lightning lane. If you're walking in Pandora and you don't know what these are actually lamps that will shoot out ultraviolet lights to help the neon paint actually glow better. Navi River Journey. We are stuck right here on Navi River Journey in Pandora. We are not moving at all. There's nobody in front of the person in front of us. I'm excited for the best part here on Navi River Journey. If you know, you know. This is my favorite part right here on Navi River Journey. This animatronic and singing is so cool. So I just got off a Navi River Journey, and something that has never happened to me happened. We actually got stuck for a period of time on Navi River Journey, where the boat in front of us just stopped moving, so we were, you know, backed up. But I am so glad I got to catch my favorite part of Navi River Journey. Nahewa, 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 Nahewa. That animatronic is so amazing. And it's probably the best part about that ride. We're about to park hop from Animal Kingdom to Hollywood Studios. But before we do, I wanted to ride Flight of Passage one more time. And of course, we got Lightning Lane, but the wait time right now is 30 minutes.
You're all clear.
Great. Now let's go.
We are leaving Animal Kingdom and park hopping to Hollywood Studios. And just like that, we park hopped from Animal Kingdom over to Hollywood Studios. We already have us a dinner reservation at Mama Melrose Restaurante. It is still raining. It's probably the worst I've seen all today, but we have to make our way all the way to Mama Melrose Restaurante for our dinner reservation, and that's all the way near the Muppets.
Okay.
as much as I am soaking wet, I am truly having an amazing time. Like, I just can't make it up. No matter if it's raining or not, any rainy day is better than a sunny day somewhere else. So we made it to Mama Melrose Restaurante, and I am a soggy bottom boy, but I'm happy to be here. I actually wanted to eat here the other day, but it just wasn't the right time. But tonight is the night. Look at how amazing Mama Melrose is. You can actually see the open kitchen right here. I love that. Look at how beautiful it is with the lights. If you've never been to Mama Melrose Restaurante, they really do have some amazing food. But like for appetizers, they have the fried fresh mozzarella, which is basically sticks. And then they have vine ripened tomatoes and fresh mozzarella, the house made Italian meatball, Mama Caesar salad, milestone soup, and margarita flatbread. For entrees, they have the charred shrimp steak, Mama's Italian pasta, they have oven baked chicken al parmigiana, the sustainable fish, spaghetti and meatballs, pork chops, and shrimp. Then of course we can't forget about the specialty drinks like the Mama's margarita, the Italian surfer, the red sangria. We got the beers on draft. We got the non-alcoholic beverages. But we got wine flights. They all sound really good right now. I'm in love with the theme here. It's kind of like old Hollywood, like brick wall with lights and vines everywhere. I love that. So I wanted to get a alcoholic beverage, and we got the Italian surfer. And our server actually recommended it to us, to saying that this was his favorite. First sip. Oh, that is good. That is really good. And you don't taste anything. So we just received table side bread, and I'm very excited to be able to dig into it. So I got the charred strip steak with the mac and cheese, and it looks so good. It actually has wine reduction on it. Okay, it's time to try the steak. Let's see. Right here beside Mama Melrose Restaurante, you can actually meet Santa from 10 to 9 at It's a Wonderful Shop. I wonder in Batu if it's raining or not, but from one galaxy to another, we are officially in Batu. And what surprised me is that Rise of the Resistance is at a 15-minute wait, but the day is at a 15-minute wait, I have a lightning lane. Right when we tried to get on Rise of the Resistance, the ride went down, so we're gonna try to wait it out and see if it comes back. But look at this. Look how cool this is. So while we wait for Rise of the Resistance to come back, we're actually gonna get on Smuggler's Run. The standby wait time is at 10 minutes. But usually I go through single rider. So I'm actually glad that we might be able to go through the entire queue and see it, because I haven't been through the real queue in so long.
Chewbacca, my fine friend!
Yes, yes. As we have reached, you let us use the ship. We'll get you the supplies you need. Pick up in wheels. You help the resistance. I get over.
Got to be the pilot, and I'm excited to see how we do. I haven't been the pilot in a long time.
You're back. I did not think I would see you again after the incident. You're braver than I thought.
For your safety, remain seated and supervise your lights.
Up or down. I can't believe that the last time I was here, they didn't even have the Christmas tree up, but it looks so beautiful. And I can't even imagine how beautiful it looks at night with the Christmas lights lit up. The rain has started again, but we're about to get on Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. And it's at a 20-minute wait. Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway is a really cute ride, but it still surprises me that this is the first ever ride that is dedicated to Mickey and Minnie.
Nothing can stop us now.
I don't know how. Poor Pluto. Oh, look at Donald Duck.
Went to your position.
Daisy Duck.
Ready? And... 1, 2, 3.
Excellent.
Now, let's...
Nothing
was gonna go wrong. Stop us
The next ride that we're gonna get on is one of my two favorite rides here at Hollywood Studios. Rockin' Roller Coaster starring Aerosmith. It's at a 25-minute wait, but we have Lightning Lane.
Hey, wait a minute. We can't leave these people here like this.
We can't?
Come on. Come on, you know how we feel about our fans.
Yeah, that's right. Well, guys, what do you expect me to do? Send them all with you?
Yeah. Wait a minute. I love that idea. How about some backstage passes?
I love that you can actually see people walking on the facade of the building. It's snowing, you got the Christmas trees. Oh, that looks so beautiful. It is time for the Tower of Terror. We got Lightning Lane. How is there nobody in line for the Tower of Terror right now? This is crazy. So the last time I was actually on this ride, we got stuck here in the elevator on the left-hand side because they were transitioning from two elevators to one, and I was told that there is two hidden Mickeys in here.
Moving into a land of both shadow and substance, of things and ideas, you've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
If you know, you know, the far left side elevator is the best.
You are the passengers in a mostly common elevator about to ascend into your very own episode of the Twilight Zone.
Thank you.
One stormy night long, that door is opening once again. This time, it's opening for you.
Look how cute this hoodie is. Got Goofy, Minnie, Mickey, Pluto, Daisy, Chip and Dale, Clarabelle. I love that. How much is it? $59.99? That's not bad. They got a Mandalorian Grogu lounge fly. I love that. How much is it? $78. They got a Disney 100 lounge fly. I love that. Cute. It's got the Disney 100 medallion on it. Look at these Christmas Crocs. Got Mickey and Minnie. Oh my. Now these are some Crocs I would actually wear. I'm not the biggest Crocs person, but I just like the insides of them and their Christmas theme. We are back in Batu and a Rise of the Resistance is back up and running. So of course we got some lightning lanes for it. It's still surprising to me, even though I know it was raining, but it's at a 20 minute wait and I'm so used to it being over 90 minutes.
Incoming transmission from Ray. BB-8, is everyone assembled? Good. Should we be in flight prep? Recruits, thank you for joining the cause. A covert resistance team led by my friend Finn has infiltrated a First Order Star Destroyer that is now headed to this system. Your outpost on Batu is no longer safe. We have transports waiting to take you to General Organa's secret base on Pokhara.
Copy that. Get us clear so we can make the jump.
Be ready. You won't have much time.
Where are all those TIE fighters coming from? Star Destroyers. We can't. We're caught in a tractor beam. It's pulling us in.
I really love how Disney created this scene right here. Stormtroopers just lined up. It is truly so amazing. And honestly, really cool.
Oh, there's something funny over here. No matter, spies. Don't know what you're talking
about. Leave us.
Yes, General.
Enemies of the First Order, we will soon snap out your meager resistance. You chose the wrong side, and now you will pay. The resistance prisoners.
You have what I want. You know the location of the secret base, and I will take it from you.
We are needed on the bridge.
Keep the prisoners here. I will return to finish this personally.
So excited to finally be back on Rise of Resistance. I love this ride. It's just always a high wait time, but it is definitely worth it.
I'm so excited.
Trouble.
Hey, you're not authorized. Wait. We're a breach. These two droids anyway.
So we just got off of Rise of the Resistance and we are headed to Toy Story Mania. It is at a 5-minute wait. I don't think I've ever seen that before, but also Slinky Dog Dash is at a 5-minute wait and I kind of want to do it even in the rain. I don't think I have ever seen Toy Story Mania at a 5-minute wait, nor have I seen Slinky Dog Dash at a 5-minute wait.
Hey, come on, come on.
So after getting off Toy Story Mania, we came to the realization that if we rode Slinky Dog Dash and Alien Swirling Saucers that we have ridden every single ride here in Hollywood Studios, that means that we did 2 parks one day. And of course, that does not include us watching Disney's Fantasmic here at Hollywood Studios, Disney's Movie Magic, and Disney's Wonderful World of Animation. They premiere at 8:45, and the first show of Fantasmic was canceled. We actually got here and they were not doing any shows anymore for Frozen or Indiana Jones Stunt Spectacular because of the time. They stopped showing after a certain period of time. Same thing with Beauty and the Beast. I don't know how I'm feeling right now because I am not the biggest fan of these type of rides, and we're on it. They're actually playing Christmas music, guys. Woo! Woo! Who knew that ASS was still making? It is now time for Slinky Dog Dash. It's a 20-minute wait now. It's no longer 5, but we have Lightning Lane. I hate this moment when I have to leave a Disney park, but I am living for all these Christmas decorations like the garlands, the street lamp, you know, decorations. It is so, so amazing. It's so beautiful. Well, with that, we're gonna call it a day here at Disney's Hollywood Studio. We started off the day rope dropping the Animal Kingdom. We actually rode every single ride there. We caught the Finding Nemo show and the Festival of the Lion King. And then we park hopped over to Hollywood Studios. We got on every single ride. And unfortunately, we didn't get here in time to watch the shows. Fantasmic was canceled due to the rain, but I really enjoyed my time here. The rain or not, it is truly amazing to be here in Disney in a rainy day. I actually love a rainy day, but a rainy day here is a better than a sunny day somewhere else. So like, comment, subscribe, and share. Ring the bell to get notified when I post more. But always remember, laughter is timeless, imagination has no age, and dreams are forever. We're about to get on a Rise of Resistance.